Guys, the groundskeeper, he didn't want to go on camera with his face, but he basically confirmed that what Dr. Image just found here, Voodoo.
This is Voodoo right there. They said they see it a lot in the cemetery. Toys with names, kids' names written in it. You know what? I touched that.
I touched it. I was digging stuff out of it. I think we need to be blessed somehow. Guys, this is a little different, right? Today you're in for a treat. We are at the Forest Hills Cemetery in Boston. It is one of the largest and most beautiful cemeteries and arboretums and nature walks. It has everything, and it's 276 acres of like awesomeness. So what better way to get around than on a bike? Come along with us, enjoy some of the scenery. We're going to also take you to a miniature village. It's incredible. It'll be interesting, so come along with us. You ready?
Yeah. All right.
How beautiful is that? Okay, so we're back, and if you notice, we're missing a key element, as you saw in the intro, the bikes. Apparently, you're not supposed to ride your bikes in here, so obviously we're going to respect that, so you're not going to see us, you know, driving around on bikes.
I was hoping to ride my bike.
But that was epic. That 5 minutes of blazing through here on the bikes was the best. But anyways, we're here. We're at Forest Hills. We can't wait to bring you along. It's 276 acres of arboretum, trails. Obviously, it's a cemetery. The most unbelievable headstones that you're ever going to see. This place is, I think it's won the list of out of the top 100 places to see in Massachusetts. And you're going to see why. So guys, that one right there, that's my favorite mausoleum that is in the cemetery. I mean, that's just my personal favorite. There are so many other gorgeous mausoleums to see here. This just happens to be my favorite. Wow. I'm actually gonna walk up behind it and just check out behind this beautiful mausoleum. Look at this. And look at the view. Show you some art installations that they have around the cemetery. They utilized some logs here and they covered it in metal, and now it's like a bench. Don't sit in it in the sun. And etched into that, it says, "Beyond the trees is a soul worth thanking." Amen to that. to show you that each one of these has a different name as to what it was. That's the musician's house. Up in the corner is the poet. Right here is the temperance leader. Temperance leader. Anybody know? I don't. Right here is the grocer. And this right there, that is the wagon driver's house. And the wagon driver actually died in a flood of molasses in the Great Molasses Flood way back in the day. Information will be linked below if you're interested, but what a way to go. Incredible. Okay guys, I just wanted to show you the scale. This is the miniature village, and this was added in 2006 and added to the National Historic Register. Christopher Frost is the artist, and each one of these little miniature houses represents an actual home of someone who's buried in this cemetery. This place is incredible, and just wanted to show you the scale of this little miniature village. Guys, we're at an old family plot, and the name of this plot, the whole family, is Bacon, not to be confused with Kevin. I had to say that, you know, that whole 6 degrees of Kevin Bacon thing. But anyways, to be on a serious note, we are going to try and do a little bit of paranormal here. Sorry about the sirens in the background as of right now, but we are going to try and catch a little bit of activity, hopefully. Doesn't always have to be nighttime, and we'll see what we can capture.
And died young. See a baby right there. Does that say infant? I don't even know, but I know it's all young children. So we're gonna try some REM pod. I got one set up. If you go near this device, it lights up, lets us know you're here. Does anybody want to communicate with us? I want to do an EVP, but there's a lot of noise from the nearby road.
Yeah, there is a lot of background noise. Hopefully right, we'll be able to try it out though.
I'm gonna try it real quick. Somebody here want to communicate with me? Talking to this device I'm holding, it can hear you.
If you're with us, please go towards that device.
What's your name?
Somebody here want to communicate with me? Talking to this device I'm holding, it can hear you.
If you're with us, please go towards that device.
What's your name?
Okay, nothing on that one.
Yeah,
but,
I don't know, guys.
Yeah, worth a try.
Yeah, it is worth a try. I mean, it does, like you say, it doesn't always have to be at night to actually get evidence. It is a little hard to distinguish if anything's going on, though, because there is a little bit of background noise and wind. But if you did hear anything, as always, drop it down below.
Lunch, man.
Might as well, you know, brought some lunch. We're in the cemetery and
we put in hours
all day. That's right, all day.
We put in hours for these videos
all
so.
Day. So here's this awesome tower right here. It's the tower you just saw in the picture previous to this right here. I don't think this is a mausoleum or anything like that. I think this is just like some sort of a lookout tower, I think.
A fire tower, maybe, back in the day, you know?
Yeah, let's see if we can get any kind of a shot in here. Basically, I'm just coming through a little grate. Let's see. Is there anything in here? Like there's like a staircase. Big time animal droppings, some old bricks. A little staircase. No, that's about as far as you can see. Pretty cool.
So there's the tower. We're basically across from it, and yeah, it is spectacular. It is spectacular. You know what else is spectacular? This right here. This is amazing. I mean, there's honestly, there's too much amazing things to stop and show you every single thing, but on certain things we are gonna highlight. And this is one of the ones that I definitely wanted to show you. Look at this. Now, the whole entire, what the? Oh, wow. Bonus, check this out, guys.
Oh, it's from the tower, so that's what it's for.
Ah.
It plays music.
So it's obviously a clock tower. Is it high noon? I don't know. What time is it?
Oh, that's crazy.
Anyways, it must be top of the hour, guys.
It's 5 of 1.
All right, it's the 5 of 1 music.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
It is.
First time catching that, guys.
Anyways. So you guys get to see that also. But anyways, as I was saying, this bottom piece right here is like one big foot made up of a bunch of like individual toes to make up this one gigantic foot. It's amazing.
It really is.
Look how detailed that is.
And then the side is like rocks. Like, I think this is an above ground jewel.
I think so. And look how beautiful the natural decay, or not even decay, the patina is just incredible. This natural occurrence of weathering. Amazing. Saddest thing, like these headstones are actually incredible. They're beds.
Literally.
Oh my goodness.
Two beds. Actually, there's three. There's another one right here.
This is crazy. I've never seen headstones like this ever in my life. Have you ever seen anything like this? Headstones are beds. Look at this, there's another bed right over here. And if you notice, next to the bed, there's actually a kneeling pillow to where you'd be saying a prayer. Look at this. Incredible, right? The detail. Can actually see the folds of the pillow and the folds of the blanket right here and the bed skirt. I mean, the detail, look at that. That actually looks like a ruffle, and it's cement, and it's a headstone to these children. Rest in peace, my God. Thank you. Now this to me is ironic. Obviously it's someone's name. It says Bliss. But that's exactly what being here is like. It has columns and everything. My God, I thought it was dragons, but I guess it's eagles. Look at that. Fern Hill Cremation Garden.
Yeah, guys, I've been here a dozen times, never seen this garden. We just drove by, so you never know what you're gonna find here.
So what do you think is in here? Just probably plaques?
Oh, man, look at that.
You guys can see that. That
yeah, I think it was Metflight.
Yeah, that was Metflight.
Yeah. Yeah, so we're right outside the actual city. And we're on Lady Fern Path.
Okay.
Alright.
So this is a cremation garden. No dogs allowed beyond this point, which I find interesting because there's no dogs allowed in this cemetery.
Okay.
So if you have to happen to sneak a dog in, he can't go beyond this point either. Alright. Oh my goodness. Alright, so these must be little urns. Plates. Yeah, little urns.
They're not all urns. Full. Look, there's only one in this area.
There's a couple up ahead. This is Peggy Gluck.
This is amazing. Look at this. I've never seen anything like this.
It's like a little maze and like a little garden path that just like snakes through, and it's beautiful. Look at this. So obviously there are some people here, but there's plenty of space.
I had no
for
idea
so much
this
more.
Was here.
Isn't this amazing?
This is so beautiful.
Wow. Look at that. And right now, everything is in bloom. I mean, everything.
Look at the colors.
See that Japanese maple?
And it's still a lot of room in here.
Look
There's
at this.
A lot of room.
Out. This is just amazing.
It's beautiful.
I mean, so each one of these squares probably represents an urn, and then, you know, you buy that little spot, and there's probably a place for families or individuals. And there's like little places to sit, like benches and stuff like that, so you can come here and.
It's so cool.
Yeah, it's so peaceful. Well, minus the regular traffic noise of the city, but in between that noise, it's really, really peaceful. This is so cool. I'm not exactly familiar with I don't remember the name, but literally they look like bells. And if you look at them really close, little bells. It's awesome.
Okay.
Okay, so what did you just find here?
I came down this path and I found this little house type of thing.
Look,
it's literally a house with a moss roof. There's a hole in it. We did not do this, guys.
Oh my god, that's kind of cool. Well, obviously, you can tell how long this has been here. Look at that.
I mean, I came down this path.
That's so awesome. Maybe there's little fairies that live here. Wow. Maybe there's little gnomes living here. Pretty cool. I like it. I guess that's where the hobbits, all the fairies live. This is a beauty. I love that. That's awesome. Wicked cool. Look at that. A forever faithful friend from 1810. Creepy.
And something caught my eye.
What did you just find? Yeah, I just saw that crazy headstone. Something told me to stop here.
I've seen trash and I'm like, there's normally no trash here. It's two things that are taped up. I don't know what I'm looking at in this cemetery, but that's taped up and that is a jar that, Marlon, you don't know what's in there. In the cemetery, okay? This could be voodoo or some what the heck's in there? There's stuff in there. And what, why is it like this, like in a hole? Were they trying to bury what?
This is heavy, whatever this is.
There's something in there. This is kind of crazy, like what the heck?
I don't know.
We should tell someone about that because
maybe we should
what
just open it.
What if there's remains in there?
What if it's like a geocache type of a thing?
But why is there aluminum foil on the inside of that?
It's rusted shut.
And it's like...
Hold on.
It's in a bag and that one's all taped up. Oh my god.
Oh, I can't even get it open. You got it? Let's see if we can...
What the heck is this?
What is that? Is that bones? Is that bones?
I don't even know what I'm looking at.
Hold that still for 1 second. I'm going to zoom in on that. I don't know. I think it looks like bones.
I don't know
I'm
what...
I'm going to shut this off so we can see what's going on.
My god, I don't even know what I just found.
So we're going in for the other one. The other one looked like it might have been bones in it. This is all sealed up with electrical tape. And we're trying to see what's in there. What's in this? Hold on, let me hold this down. Hold on.
What the hell? I think this is some kind of voodoo stuff.
What the hell?
Yeah. Look at that.
Is that bones?
I don't know what that is. Look at that.
Is it food?
I mean, why would food be all buried like that?
Peel this back. Hold on a second. What is going on? The tinfoil on the inside of that jar. What is in that jar? It looks like flesh colored.
Okay. I don't even know what we found here, but... It's like this. Oh, kinds
it's of, like... Is it in a liquid?
This.
There's like tinfoil and stuff?
Like a voodoo type of thing.
What the hell would somebody be trying to seal up?
I mean, this one's open on that side. I wish I had some gloves. You don't have any plastic gloves.
No, I might. Let me look. All right, so we found the groundskeepers, and we're going to have them check it out.
I just found two jars.
I mean, look at this. We were actually filming it. You know what I mean?
I was going to call, like, the office.
I'm like...
I don't know if someone's,
it almost looks like...
Someone's
look at this.
Trying to bury something over here.
Look at this.
Look at that. These were right here, dude. Like that.
Look at that.
And
like, what the hell?
Like a little hole here.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know what that is.
So you've actually, that's voodoo? That's 100% voodoo.
You don't want
I'm not recording your face. Nah, I'm recording
right,
you down.
He doesn't want to record. All right. Now. Wow, but so you guys just leave that here then?
Somebody left that for voodoo?
Don't touch. Yeah. Don't touch. Oh, man.
Don't touch?
Listen.
Oh, man. We gotta go say a prayer.
I heard a woman's voice go.
We heard something. Like, I'm not even kidding. Don't think we're crazy. Hello? Oh my god, this is crazy.
You work here, huh?
Yeah,
this is a beautiful time.
Have you ever seen anything or something like this before?
Yeah, you saw all the time.
I saw like chicken down with the head.
You saw a chicken cut off? Oh my god.
He said he saw a toy. He opened it and there was a kid's name. It's voodoo, I told you.
Yeah. Alright, it's voodoo.
Alright,
thank you. Alright, we're out of here. Guys, the groundskeeper, he didn't want to go on camera with his face, but he basically confirmed that. What darker image just found here?
This is voodoo right here. And they said they see it a lot in the cemetery. They've seen toys with names, kids' names written in it. You know what? I touched that.
I touched it. I was digging stuff out of it. I think we need to be blessed somehow. We need to find a church. Or we need to, like, do you have stuff?
What I'm going to do is here. Hold my camera for a minute. I'm just gonna put this right back where it was.
Now we're even touching this even more.
I know, but at least we're gonna close it right back up and we're gonna put it right.
We need to re-sanitize.
Okay.
All right. Oh my God.
All right, guys. I didn't know what I found. I thought for a minute, but I mean,
what did he say? He said that he found a chicken, like with a
chickens
with the head cut off.
He found children's toys.
That's crazy.
With names written inside of it, and they, I said, what do you guys think?
This just took a turn. This is pretty crazy.
Yeah, it is. I can't believe that. Are you kidding me? Voodoo?
So I guess there's some voodoo things that happen in the cemetery, and people either leave items or apparently they kill chickens and leave their bodies here for some reason. And toys have been stuffed with children's names and stuff like that. I don't even know what's going on here, but today really did take an interesting turn. And I don't know. That's so weird. Something said stop here. Look at that headstone right there, which is that headstone that I was just looking at. The one with the crazy face right there. And then you were over here and you're like, oh my God. And then, wow. This is some Santeria type stuff.
After we opened one of the jars to see what the hell it was, I heard a woman.
Yeah, you were just saying that.
And there's no one around.
Nobody.
And then the guys told us it's voodoo.
Wow. Yeah, we just like literally flagged down that groundskeeper. And he literally said this has happened before. I don't know what we're supposed to do. I mean, you know, what do you do in a case like this?
We closed it back up.
Do we need to say something?
I just want to say a couple words. I don't know. I mean, it can't hurt. You know, dear Lord, or, you know, Father above, please watch over us and protect us, and may nothing attach to us and follow us home. And thank you, Jesus, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
All right, guys, what do you think? That's the main gate behind us. That's the view that I kind of wanted to give you, if you can see that. You're a little off-center now. You're kind of leaning in a parking lot. But anyways, I just wanted to say thanks for coming along. This has been amazing, and the day took a turn, and it was really interesting.
Some wild stuff, yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know. That was kind of crazy.
It was, yeah.
And I don't know. We need to go find a priest or something until the next time.